By the divine authority of the Templar, you are hereby exiled to the forsaken shores of Reyklast. You have transgressed against God and consorted with sin. Find your redemption, exile, or die in the attempt. Why do the keen of mind seek to satiate their curiosity in darkness and depravity? Innocence is our father. You were born to be swift and strong. What did you do with your gifts, duelist? You squandered them on self-indulgence. Sin has led you here, your path inked in the blood of gratuitous murder. You have betrayed the Grand Arena. Now Reyklast shall be your audience and your foe. Why do the keen of mind seek to satiate their curiosity in darkness and depravity? Innocence is our father. Arioth is our mother. When a daughter strays from the light, she makes her swift and silent. You stole the bounty of others. A crow that plunders our crops. A stray dog that slaughters our sheep. Arioth is a land of men, not animals. Think on that, Ranger. When Reyklast shows you how to truly live like an animal. Do you think you are savage enough to face the land of the damned, Marauder? We offered you truth, yet still you clasped your superstitious lies. You were born with quickness of body and sharpness of mind. How have you paid for these gifts? With innocent blood. Yours is a predatory profession, the business of butchery. You have stolen many a life to fill your purse. Now you will earn your redemption in Reyklast. You swore sinew and soul to serve God and the Order of the Templar. For years you built a life upon faith, only to smite it asunder with one sinful blow. And is that not the greatest folly of all? To lose faith when it's all you have left? You were once the chosen of God, a Templar. You are now the chosen of Reyklast, an exile. Why do the keen of mind seek to satiate their curiosity in darkness and depravity? Innocence is our father. Arioth is our mother. When a daughter strays from the light, she makes herself an orphan. Learn well the lessons that Reyklast will teach you, witch. It is your only hope of finding your way home. You were born to be swift and strong. What did you do with your gifts, duelist? You squandered them on self-indulgence. You were born with quickness of body and sharpness of mind. How have you paid for these gifts? With innocent blood. Yours is a predatory profession, the business of butchery. Why do the keen of mind seek to satiate their curiosity in darkness and depravity? Innocence is our father. Arioth is our mother. When a daughter strays from the light, she makes herself an orphan. Learn well the lesson.
the very sand shivers with malice. There's a power here that welcomes me.
Sure. Alive, anyway. Looks like you found something you can defend yourself with. Good. This place is crawling with criminals. There's smoke rising just east of here. Could be worth checking if there's...
The dead will soon rise for me, not against me. thought I'd be a dead woman by now.
far of Beecham, you have transgressed against your god and your fellow man. You have been a willing vessel for the following sins. Unlawful avarice, one count of possessing stolen goods. Civil envy, one count of resisting Templar authority. God has charged me with your redemption. You are hereby exiled to Rayclast, where it is hoped you shall come to repent your sins and make your peace with your beloved father.
Fine work with Hillock. Where'd you learn to fight like that? No, forget I asked. We exiles have no history. Dominus took it from us when he had his blackguards dump us in the water out there. Here, got something for you. Should help you kill a few more of those undead bastards. Don't bother thanking me. The way I figure it, the longer we fighters live, the longer everyone lives. Founded by Marseus Lioneye as a supply station for his campaigns against the Karui. In its day, Lioneye's watch could be defended by just a small garrison of well-armed legionnaires. What have I got? A handful of starving criminals with driftwood clubs and rusted hatchets. The Eternal Empire has some right nasty leftovers. Whether it's something in the air or in the water, no one stays dead in Rayclast. Not the first time. Can take a little while, but sooner or later, corpses wake up and go looking for breakfast. I've seen many an exile pass through Lioneye's watch, and many more that simply pass on. Those letters are my way of keeping track, of remembering. Aurith might want to forget us all, but I'll be damned if I will. Welcome. still alive, are we?
A wayfish, waterlogged witch, washed up in raid clothes. That's the first line of the poem I'm writing about you, exile. Easy, girl. You could scorch a bloke with a look like that. The name's Bestel, captain of the good ship Merry Go. At last, my Merry Go's gone. My crew is gone. But my wits remain, after a fashion.
Tarkly rescued from the waves, a stricken Bestel, fate's slave. From fallen crew and broken bark, Bestel lives thanks to Tarkly.
Aral, the Merry Gull's cook, washed up on the rocks over yonder. Dead as a doornail he was, buried him myself. Then, a few days later, I see him on the beach. A little worse for wear, but upright, shuffling about. A land full of disturbing surprises, this Rayclast.
I saw what you did to Hillock out there, witch. Your black art is the reason you're here, in exile. It may also be the only thing that allows you to see another dawn. I'm Nessa, and I suppose I should thank you for ridding us of that putrid giant. Back in Aureus, I judged your kind without hesitation. In Rayclast, I don't have that luxury. Lioneye's watch isn't much, but it's ours. We could use you here, while you live. But should you wish to venture out, do just one thing for me. Out on the coast, amongst the wrecks, there must be a ship's medicine chest. I have many to care for, and there's only so much I can do with herbs and seawater. Tarkley's as good a man as you can find on this godforsaken coast. He has some wrongs to right, no doubt. What they are, I've never asked, and I never will. If not for Tarkley, we'd all be dead. The Merry Gull ran aground on the Tidal Island trying to escape from pirates, as tends to happen here in Rayclast. Her crew met a far worse fate. Cannibals. Tarkley pulled Bestel from some hideaway in the wreckage. The ship's only survivor. Whether the ordeal fractured his mind or whether it was just in his nature all along, it's clear that Bestel sails a different course to the rest of us.
There's an island, a hop, skip and a wade offshore of the terraces. That's where my Mary Gull ran aground. Watched the locals spit roast the ship's doctor, but his medicine chest might still be there, amongst the splinters and bones. It'd have everything Nessa might need. Dr. Shaky Hands Opton was lousy with a scalpel and even worse with a saw, but he knew his apothecary. Explains the shaky hands, if you ask me. Poor Nessa. Not even a mother herself, and yet she cares for us all. And what a sickly, pathetic brood we are. May she live to have her own family, a real family. If anyone deserves that, Nessa does.
I know that stench, just like my sisters, upon the pyre.
Thank you.
learn is to live. Much clatter. Much clatter. Much clatter.
Fish the waters, fill the air with song. The card we wave is yet a secret. Grows, gains in pride and power every day. Khan has kept his promise The time of the Kari. Calm has removed the...
What little help I can offer is you. While we live, we are blessed.
Much clutter. much clatter. Much clatter.
I'd almost stop believing in miracles. This medicine chest, it's greater than the serums and salves it holds. It tells us that we can do more in Rayclass than merely suffer. I've not much to offer in return, but please, take something in thanks for what you've done. farewell.
So, you managed to salvage Shaky Hand's druggery. Nicely done. Nessa will put it to good use. More than that, benumbed quack Optin ever did.
Got a job for you, if you're willing. There's a pool near the mudflats needs investigating. You'll smell it before you see it. Stinks like a carcass in high summer. That's not the worst of it. Dead birds walking. Animals don't rise up again the same as people do here. So if they aren't raising themselves, what's doing it for them? The answer's in that fetid pool. Clear the place out and kill whatever's raising those rowers. We've got enough living dead to contend with already.
switch clatter.
Thank you.
Odin's canoe struck this